the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
We have come rejoicing into the house of the Lord for this celebration, dear brothers and sisters. And now we stand with Luke and Karmyn on the day they intend to form a home of their own. For them, this is a moment of unique importance. So let us support them with our affection, with our friendship, and with our prayer as their brothers and sisters. Let us listen attentively with them to the word that God speaks to us today. And with Holy Church, let us humbly pray to God the Father through Christ our Lord for this couple, his servants, that he lovingly accept them, bless them, and make them always one.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you. We glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, O God, almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world. Mercy on us. Take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who consecrated the bond of marriage by so great a mystery, that in the wedding covenant you foreshadow the sacrament of Christ and his church, grant, we pray, to these your servants, that what they receive in faith they may live out in deeds. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
A reading from the book of Genesis. The Lord God said, "It is not good for the man to be alone. I will make a suitable partner for him." So the Lord God formed out of the ground various wild animals and various birds of the air. And he brought them to the man to see what he would call them. Whatever the man called each of them would be its name. The man gave names to all the cattle, all the birds of the air, and all wild animals. But none proved to be the suitable partner for the man. So the Lord God cast a deep sleep on the man, and while he was asleep, he took out one of his ribs and closed up its place with flesh. The Lord God then built up into a woman the rib that he had taken from the man. When he brought her to the man said, This one at last is bone of my bones and flesh of my flesh. This one shall be called woman, for out of her man this one has been taken. That is why a man leaves his father and mother and clings to his wife, and the two of them become one body. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Judgment endow the king, and with your justice the king's son. He shall govern your people with justice, and your afflicted ones with judgment. Lord, every nation on earth will adore you. Justice shall flower in his days, and profound peace till the world be no more. May he rule from sea to sea, and from the river to the ends of the earth. Lord, every nation on earth will adore you. The kings of Tarshish and the isles shall offer gifts. The kings of Arabia and Saba shall bring tribute. All kings shall pay him homage. All nations shall serve him. Lord, every nation on earth will adore you. For he shall rescue the poor when he cries out, and the afflicted when he has no one to help him. He shall have pity for the lowly and the poor. The lives of the poor he shall save. Lord, every nation on earth will adore you.
A reading from the book of Revelation. I, John, heard what sounded like a loud voice of a great multitude in heaven saying, Alleluia. Salvation, glory, and might belong to our God. A voice coming from the throne said, Praise our God, all you his servants, and you who revere him, small and great. Then I heard something like the sound of a great multitude, or the sound of rushing water, or mighty peals of thunder, as they said, Alleluia. The Lord has established his reign, our God the Almighty. Let us rejoice and be glad and give him glory. For the wedding day of the Lamb has come. His bride has made herself ready. She was allowed to wear a bright, clean linen garment. The linen represents the righteous deeds of the holy ones. Then the angel said to me, "Write this. Blessed are those who have been called to the wedding feast of the Lamb." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus raised his eyes to heaven and said, "I pray not only for my disciples, but also for those who will believe in me through their word, so that they may all be one, as you, Father, are in me and I in you, that they also may be in us, that the world may believe that you sent me. And I have given them the glory you gave me, so that they may be one as we are one, I in them and you in me, that they may be brought to perfection as one, that the world may know that you sent me and that you loved them even as you loved me. Father, they are your gift to me. I wish that where I am, they also may be with me, that they may see my glory that you gave me, because you loved me before the foundation of the world. Righteous Father, the world also does not know you, but I know you, and they know that you sent me. I made known to them your name, and I will make it known, that the love with which you loved me may be in them, and I in them."
The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
What a beautiful day. What a beautiful day in quite the beautiful church. What a privilege it is to be able to celebrate with you today. I realize that my face might look quite unfamiliar for many of you. So by way of introduction, I am Father Nathaniel. I'm a monk and priest of St. Meinrad Archabbey down in southern Indiana. And once upon a time, when I was growing up, I was a parishioner of St. Robert of Newminster in this diocese, just down the way in Ada. And I remember the VonEhr family there at that parish. And interestingly enough, Karmyn's dad was my chemistry teacher, my AP chemistry teacher back in high school, years ago. Nonetheless, it's really good to be back here, to be back in this diocese, and to be able to reconnect with Karmyn and Luke. And Karmyn and I, again, reconnected back in 2018. So she worked a summer down in St. Meinrad in southern Indiana, my monastery, and that's where we reconnected. And it's been a blessing to be able to get to know Luke along the way as well, especially as we get to celebrate a big day of change. And you know, very few people like change. Maybe we're adventurous, and perhaps we like to explore the world in different ways and in different places, but there's still something about what's familiar to us that keeps us coming back. Today, all of us gathered here, family and friends from near and far, today we get to celebrate change. And how fitting that is as we begin this new year where maybe we're still following through on our resolutions if we've made them. How fitting it is that we get to celebrate change as we commemorate the Epiphany of our Lord this Sunday, the revelation of the birth of Christ Jesus into our world of flesh and blood, a development which alters the course of our world forever. Luke and Karmyn, the change we celebrate today, this celebration of your marriage, this change from one way of life to another, is an image of who God is for us. And sometimes this change can really be a surprise. Luke, remember when you first met Karmyn? You weren't really looking for a date at the time, but there Karmyn was. It's like God was stirring something up within you, almost like he's waking you up from sleep, like Adam in the garden, right? This one at last is bone of my bones and flesh of my flesh. And I know, Karmyn, that you were saying the same thing. God was certainly giving you a chance to share life with one another, even to the point of where we are today, ready to share life with one another as one witness of God's love for the world. So how can your marriage today be an image of God's overflowing love for the world? A tough question for sure. But maybe here's a start. You have a great view, but check out all the people out there. Every single one of them. Look at your friends. They're here, we're here to support you, to celebrate you. Take a look at your family, right in the front rows, interspersed beyond. They're here too, being here to lift you up in prayer before God, for sure, but also as an example of what God's love can accomplish. Sure, it might be a little messy, it's not ever flawless, but even in the difficulties and hard times, their desire for you is still a witness of God's overflowing love in some way. Let this witness move you deeper into what you desire most, that God make the two of you one in his mercy
and one in his love. It's because of this love that a man clings to his wife and a wife to her husband, becoming one body. And that's no easy task. It's hard. It pulls us outside ourselves. We can't just look after our own interests anymore, because that takes sacrifice. Learning to love our spouse even when he or she angers us, that takes sacrifice. Saying no to going out with friends because the kids are home, that takes sacrifice. Making amends with our spouse after a fight, that takes sacrifice. Accepting the faults of our spouse, owning up to our own faults, that takes sacrifice. And Luke and Karmyn, the vows which you're about to proclaim, I promise to be faithful to you in good times and in bad, in sickness and in health, to love you and to honor you all the days of my life. That takes sacrifice, a lifelong sacrifice, a sacrifice of absolutely everything, a complete sacrifice, a giving of all of who you are to your spouse, holding nothing back, bearing it all, and receiving everything of your spouse in return, turning nothing away, accepting it all with patience and mercy and love, accepting it all with outstretched arms. This is the sacrifice. This is the love that reveals God to us. For Jesus, that same love landed him on the cross. God loved us so much, he sent us his only Son. He died for us because of this love, all to make us one. One with one another, and one with God. And so, Luke and Karmyn, in a few short moments, when you exchange your vows, you'll be freely choosing this love for yourselves. You'll be freely choosing this love God has revealed to us. You'll be freely choosing to be a witness of this love to us all. And it's this love that you've been preparing for. But see, here's the irony in this love that you've been preparing for. Preparation implies looking into the future. Think about all the planning that went into this wedding. Maybe I don't need to remind you, right? But guest list and finding a church and rehearsal dinner and reception food and wedding dress and tuxedo rentals, and the list goes on and on. You know, each of these things carefully planned with the future in mind. This love that you're freely choosing today, this love that you've been preparing for, it's not really about looking to some future time. Yes, it's true that hopefully your love together here on earth prepares you for your love of God in eternal life. But this kind of preparation can only happen where your feet are. It can only happen in the present moment, because it's there, in the present moment, that God reveals himself to us every single day. So this marriage marks the first day of this change, which we celebrate. This first day of a new beginning, the start of a new covenant, a new commitment, a daily commitment. With her vows, Karmyn promises to show the face of God to Luke in this present moment, day by day, in good times and in bad, in sickness and in health. And with his vows, Luke promises to show the face of God to Karmyn in this present moment, day by day, loving her and honoring her all the days of his life. They're growing together as husband and wife in who God created them to be, founded in God's love. And so, Luke and Karmyn, you're in this together. And we're all here to support you in whatever life may bring. Your witness today and for the rest of your lives is a sign of God's love for us. Today, you're not just signing up to be on the same team because of the last name you'll share. You'll become one, wrapped in a love that binds so tight, nothing can separate you. A love so tight that you're sharing the same mission, to be a sign and a witness of God's love, to be a sign and a witness of God Himself for all of us and for the whole world.
Dearly beloved, you have come together into the house of the church so that in the presence of the church's minister and the community, your intention to enter into marriage may be strengthened by the Lord with a sacred seal. Christ abundantly blesses the love that binds you. Through a special sacrament, he enriches and strengthens those he has already consecrated by holy baptism that they may be faithful to each other forever and assume all the responsibilities of married life. And so in the presence of the church, I ask you to state your intentions. Luke and Karmyn, have you come here to enter into marriage without coercion, freely and wholeheartedly?
I have.
Are you prepared as you follow the path of marriage to love and honor each other for as long as you both shall live?
I am.
Are you prepared to accept children lovingly from God and to bring them up according to the law of Christ and His church? Since it is your intention to enter the covenant of holy matrimony, join your right hands and declare your consent before God and His church. May the Lord in His kindness strengthen the consent you have declared before the church and graciously bring to fulfillment His blessing within you. What God joins together, let no one put asunder. Let us bless the Lord. Thanks be to God. May the Lord bless these rings, which you will give to each other as a sign of love and fidelity. Dear brothers and sisters, as we call to mind the special gift of grace and charity by which God has been pleased to crown and consecrate the love of our sister Karmyn and our brother Luke, let us commend them to the Lord.
That Luke and Karmyn, newly joined in holy matrimony, may be granted perfect and fruitful love, peace and strength, and that they bear faithful witness to the name of Jesus. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the grace of the sacrament will be renewed by the Holy Spirit in all married persons here present. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the families gathered here, may they experience the abundant love and peace of Christ in hope of the salvation to come. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the unity of all Christian people, that they grow in an openness to the movement of the Holy Spirit, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all members of our families who have passed from this world, especially Wilson Best, Shirley VonEhr, Robert and Marcella Mulderink, Charles Jensen, and for all the departed, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Graciously pour out upon this husband and wife, O Lord, the spirit of your love, to make them one heart and one soul, so that nothing whatever may divide those you have joined, and no harm come to those you have filled with your blessing. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Receive in your kindness, Lord, the offerings we bring in gladness before you, and in your fatherly love, watch over those you have joined in a sacramental covenant through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For in him you have made a new covenant with your people, so that as you have redeemed man and woman by the mystery of Christ's death and resurrection, so in Christ you might make them partakers of divine nature and joint heirs with him of heavenly glory. In the union of husband and wife, you give a sign of Christ's loving gift of grace, so that the sacrament we celebrate might draw us back more deeply into the wondrous design of your love. And so with angels and all the saints, we praise you, and without end we acclaim. Therefore, most merciful Father, we make humble prayer and petition through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, that you accept and bless these gifts, these offerings, these holy and unblemished sacrifices, which we offer you firstly for your holy Catholic Church. Be pleased to grant her peace, to guard, unite, and govern her throughout the whole world, together with your servant Francis, our Pope, and David, our Bishop, and all those who, holding to the truth, hand on the Catholic and Apostolic faith. Remember, Lord, your servants, and all gathered here whose faith and devotion are known to you. For them we offer you this sacrifice of praise, or they offer it for themselves and all who are dear to them, for the redemption of their souls, in hope of health and well-being, and paying their homage to you, the eternal God, living and true. In communion with those whose memory we venerate, especially the glorious ever-Virgin Mary, Mother of our God and Lord Jesus Christ, and blessed Joseph, her spouse, your blessed apostles and martyrs, Peter and Paul, Andrew, James, John, Thomas, James, Philip, Bartholomew, Matthew, Simon and Jude, Linus, Cletus, Clement, Sixtus, Cornelius, Cyprian, Lawrence, Chrysogonus, John and Paul, Cosmas and Damian, and all your saints, we ask that through their merits and prayers in all things we may be defended by your protecting help. Therefore, Lord, we pray, graciously accept this oblation of our service, the offering of your servants Luke and Karmyn, and of your whole family, who entreat your majesty on their behalf. And as you have brought them to their wedding day, so gladden them with your gift of the children they desire, and bring them in your kindness to the length of days for which they hope. Be pleased, O God, we pray, to bless, acknowledge, and approve this offering in every respect. Make it spiritual and acceptable, so that it may become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, he took bread in his holy and venerable hands, and with eyes raised to heaven, to you, O God, his almighty Father, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took this precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands, and once more giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
The history of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the Blessed Passion, the resurrection from the dead, and the glorious ascension into heaven of Christ your Son, our Lord, we, your servants and your holy people, offer to your glorious majesty from the gifts that you have given us this pure victim, this holy victim, this spotless victim, the holy bread of eternal life and the chalice of everlasting salvation. Be pleased to look upon these offerings with a serene and kindly countenance, and to accept them as once you were pleased to accept the gifts of your servant Abel the just, the sacrifice of Abraham, our father in faith, and the offering of your high priest Melchizedek, a holy sacrifice, a spotless victim. In humble prayer, we ask you, Almighty God, command that these gifts be borne by the hands of your holy angel to your altar on high in the sight of your divine majesty, so that all of us who through this participation at the altar receive the most holy body and blood of your Son may be filled with every grace and heavenly blessing. Remember also, Lord, your servants who have gone before us with the sign of faith and rest in the sleep of peace. Grant them, O Lord, we pray, and all who sleep in Christ, a place of refreshment, light, and peace. To us also, your servants who, though sinners, hope in your abundant mercies, graciously grant some share in fellowship with your holy apostles and martyrs, with John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, Ignatius, Alexander, Marcellinus, Peter, Felicity, Perpetua, Agatha, Lucy, Agnes, Cecilia, Anastasia, and all your saints. Admit us, we beseech you, into their company, not weighing our merits, but granting us your pardon, through Christ our Lord, through whom you continue to make all these good things, O Lord. You sanctify them, fill them with life, bless them, and bestow them upon us.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen, amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Let us pray to the Lord for this bride and groom who come to the altar as they begin their married life, that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, they may always be bound together by love for one another. Holy Father, who formed man in your own image, male and female, you created them, so that as husband and wife, united in body and heart, they might fulfill their calling in the world. O God, who to reveal the great design you formed in your love, willed that the love of spouses for each other should foreshadow the covenant you graciously made with your people, so that by fulfillment of the sacramental sign, the mystical marriage of Christ with his church might become manifest in the union of husband and wife among your faithful. Graciously stretch out your right hand over these your servants, Luke and Karmyn, we pray, and pour into their hearts the power of the Holy Spirit. Grant, O Lord, that as they enter upon this sacramental union, they may share with one another the gifts of your love, and by being for each other a sign of your presence, become one heart and one mind. May they also sustain, O Lord, by their deeds, the home they are forming, and prepare their children to become members of your heavenly household by raising them in the way of the gospel. Graciously crown with your blessings your daughter Karmyn, so that by being a good wife and mother, she may bring warmth to her home with a love that is pure and adorn it with welcoming graciousness. Bestow a heavenly blessing also, O Lord, on Luke, your servant, that he may be a worthy, good, and faithful husband and a provident father. Grant, Holy Father, that desiring to approach your table as a couple joined in marriage in your presence, they may one day have the joy of taking part in your great banquet in heaven through Christ our Lord. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
On you stay, qui tollis peccata mundi, miserere nobis. On you Deus Dei, qui tollis peccata mundi, miserere. Tollis peccata mundi, dona nobis pacem.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Judgment to the King, to a King's Son, your justice, that he may judge your people in justice and your poor in right judgment. May the mountains bring forth peace for the people, and the hills justice. In his days shall justice flourish, and great peace till the moon is no more. We have seen his star, let us adore the Lord. He shall rule from sea to sea, from the river to the bounds of the earth. The kings of Tarshish and the islands shall pay him tribute. The kings of Sheba and Seba shall bring him gifts. Before him all kings shall fall prostrate, all nations shall serve him. We have seen his star, let us adore the Lord. For he shall save the needy when they cry, the poor and and those who are helpless. May his name endure forever. His name continue like the sun. Every tribe shall be blessed in him. All nations shall call him blessed. We have seen his star. Let us adore the Lord. Blessed be the Lord, God of Israel, who alone works wonders. We have seen his star. Let us adore the Lord.
Let us pray. Having been made partakers at your table, we pray, O Lord, that those who are united by the sacrament of marriage may always hold fast to you and proclaim your name to the world through Christ our Lord.
Come back in just a minute. I have a final word from Father Ron Hutchinson, the rector of the Basilica, so I invite you to please be seated for a moment.
As Father Rob just said, my name is Father Ron Hutchinson. I'm the rector here at the Basilica. And on behalf of the Basilica of St. Adalbert community, I wish to congratulate Karmyn and Luke on their wedding. Karmyn and Luke are my parishioners, which is why their wedding is here, okay? Not just because it's a beautiful church, but because it is their parish. And we ask God's choicest blessings upon them as they begin their lives together. I have to say, many years ago when I began my relationship with the Mulderink family as the director of priestly vocations, I knew that we would get at least one through, okay? And that has been the case, and Father Rob happened to have been my parochial vicar here at the Basilica. But even though as disappointing as it may have been at the moment, when Luke told me that he was no longer continuing in seminary, I have a belief that he will still find a way to do great things for God, the church, and for Karmyn as well, and specifically for this parish, of which he's a member. I'm gonna say that again, okay? I want them to remember that, okay? May God bless you, let his face shine upon you and be gracious to you, and let his countenance pour out upon you this day and every day, through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Amen.
One final note and announcement. At the end of Mass, Karmyn and Luke want to have a picture with as many of you as possible. So, at the conclusion of Mass, just ask you to go out through the front doors and line up on the front steps. And if we all move quickly, then we won't stand in the cold for too long. But just line up on the front steps for the picture. If you don't want to be in the picture, if you need to get going, then you can go out through the side door. You'll be missing out big time, okay, if we want you there. The front steps right after Mass for the picture. Please stand. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Bow down for the blessing.
May God, the eternal Father, keep you of one heart in love for one another, that the peace of Christ may dwell in you and abide always in your home.
Amen.
Amen.
May you be blessed in your children, have solace in your friends, and enjoy true peace with everyone.
Amen.
May you be witnesses in the world to God's charity, so that the afflicted and needy who have known your kindness may one day receive you thankfully into the eternal dwelling of God.
Amen.
May Almighty God bless all of you who are gathered here, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.